Well, viewers, next week, Friday, the 19th of July, will mark the UK launch of the brand new movie produced and directed by Saudi Arabia's first female filmmaker.
That's right. Haifaa Al Mansour will be joining us very shortly. Before she does, let's take a look at the movie. This is Wadjda.
وجدة وين غطوتك؟
بأشي سيكل عشان سابق عبد الله.
وبعدين إذا ركبتي سيكل ما تقدري تحملين ولا تجيبين عيال.
غالي عليك.
بعطيك 10 ريال.
20.
والله.
إي والله.
والله يعني ما تدري بنات ما يركبون السياكل.
اللي تدري زين عن وش أتكلم، وتدري ما بيك تبيع سيكل لأي أحد. شريط منوعات بما احنا صرنا اصحاب الان.
شو رايك في الفستان؟ تلقين بيعجب ابوك؟
تجيب لي وعدوه.
احنا عارفين الاثنين انه ما راح يصير.
ما عندكم سالفه غير العرس.
ايش عندك واقفه عنده؟ اشترت عائله ابوك المبجله.
تحبينه؟
ابوك؟ ابوك كان اول رجل في حياتي وان شاء الله الاخير.
يعني شو نسوي فيك الحين؟ نطردك؟
وكل هذا ليش؟ عشان ما خليتك تشتري زيتون؟
طيب بعطيك 5 ريال لو وقفتي الصياح.
تحسبين انك تقدرين تسوي اللي تبينه وما حد يدري عنك؟
طيب ايش رايك نزوجك؟
اها ما يضحك.
إذا بغيتي شيء ما حد يقدر عليك.
واجدة.
MashaAllah, very interesting looking movie. Welcome to the show. It's producer and director Haifaa Al Mansour.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Welcome indeed.
Mabruk alaikum shahr Ramadan.
Ameen. Jazakallah khair. To you too. I mean, first of all, I'm amazed. A whole list of awards and critical acclaim. The first film ever made, first feature film ever made, produced, directed entirely in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. You must be very proud.
Oh no, I'm really proud. And Saudi Arabia is changing. It's opening up and there is space for women and arts. And I'm really excited to be part of what is happening. And yeah, it was hard though, filming in Saudi. You know, we have a lot of TV in Saudi Arabia, but film is still not part of the culture. So a lot of people were hesitant and we had permission, but yet it's still people weren't like, were nervous when it comes to film. So I'm really relieved that the film is out now and so people can enjoy it.
Lovely. And Haifaa, you actually, you know, just seeing that clip, there are lots of women in that clip. There's Wadjda herself, there's her mother and other female characters. Would you say this is truly a women's film?
Oh yeah, of course it's a women's film. Yeah. Well, I come from Saudi, and in Saudi, the society, when you are part of the society, it's always like women live around among other women, and you get to know schools that are all girls, and that is my world. I come from a small town in Saudi Arabia, and I went to public school all my life, so I wanted to capture that. I think there is a lot of intimacy in it, and I wanted to put a human face on the culture. Mm. Saudi Arabia is always portrayed in the news, like in either economy or politics, and people forget to see the humans behind all the stories.
And I love what I've seen of the film so far. I mean, I'm a really big film fan, and for me, I'm not an action. I don't like action films. I don't like kids' films that much. I like human stories. And from what I've seen of that, I can't wait to see it. What was your inspiration? Because the way you were talking there, I think there's something a little bit autobiographical about it, isn't there? There is, because you mentioned that you're from a small town and Wadjda's from just the suburbs. Yeah. Sorry, and she's a very strong female and she wants to achieve this goal. She has this goal. What was your inspiration for the film?
I wanted to make a film about victorious characters that will never give in. It's the give up. It's about embracing the love of life. It is not about, it's not about complaining about how the situation is difficult in the Middle East and for women. Sometimes it is, but it is very important to move beyond that. What can we do to improve the situation? How we can have a dream and pursue that dream? And it is about more about everyday life. I was very much influenced by The Bicycle Thief.
I want to go back to the logistics of filming in Saudi Arabia. And I know that you did a lot of your filming in Riyadh, right?
Yes.
The capital of Saudi Arabia.
Yes.
So you're a woman, obviously, we can all see that. But we know there's segregation in Saudi Arabia. We know that men and women often are separated for obviously the Islamic reasons that we all understand and appreciate. How is it like, though, filming in an Islamic environment, but as a female director, in essence, a female leader?
I don't know if it's Islamic or it's the culture. I come from originally from a small
mm-hmm.
town next to Riyadh
mm-hmm.
called Zilfi, and it's very segregated a long time ago, and it is like, that is how it is, the culture there.
Mm.
So for me, I was in a van, like how it is, like because when we go outside, we're not supposed, men and women are not supposed to mix in public. So I was in a van, and I had a monitor and a walkie-talkie, and I screamed at everybody.
You screamed at
everybody,
right?
Like, from the back of a van. My voice was certainly heard. And it was very difficult, really frustrating not to be with the actors right there and then.
Yeah.
And change the blocking and things like that. But for me, it made me work harder to find the essence of this, if each scene. And as a filmmaker, I worked hard. And I don't like to stop at obstacles. That, for me, I'm not an activist who like goes and like a slogan here. I don't want to clash with the culture.
Sure.
If that is the way things are done, I will do it. For me, the aim is to make a film, a poetic film about a young girl who wants to have a dream and like, yeah.
I mean, you've clearly done that. As I said, critical acclaim. It's won loads of awards. It's been, the critics are raving about it. Where can we see it? When are we going to see it? And have you got the next project in mind already now? Because I know what you film directors are like. You're always thinking ahead.
Oh, yeah, I have projects, but I don't know how it will go. But I'm glad that the film will come in theatres. So the pictures, our distributor, bringing it to the UK, all across the United Kingdom on July 19. So I hope people go and see it. And
can't wait to see it. I'm definitely going to watch it with my family, inshallah.
Right.
So, Haifaa Al Mansour, thank you so much for joining us on Living the Life.
No, thank you so much for having me.
Well, viewers, after the break, Islam Channel's Saudia Chowdhury acquaints herself with talented photographer Anthony Epps.
That's right. That's all coming up in just a few minutes. Don't go anywhere. Stay with us here on Living the Life. See you in just a minute.